Welcome to Anoka High School for CTN's live coverage of high school volleyball. Northwest Suburban Conference Showdown as the Tornadoes host the Coon Rapids Cardinals. Joe Yon, Howie Shapiro, sidelines, and Howie, a team in Anoka that's coming in pretty strong. They're on a great streak and facing a team in the Cardinals that has struggled to gain much momentum at all this season.
Anoka, as we talk about, there's head coach John Enns. Anoka winning five in a row, Joe, as they take the court here tonight. And talking to Coach Enns today, they're just looking for some continuity, a little bit of chemistry, and they're trying to find that here, and they've had a difficult time. I didn't get a lot of chance to talk to Coach Fenwick. He didn't get a chance to get back to me today, but he did give me a high five, so that's all good.
His team has the home crowd behind it, and of course that win streak as well. There's a look at your starting lineups for the visiting Cardinals. Paige Fossland is the center, the outside hitter Becca Masteler, the middle hitters Sophia Frakey and Ellie Hintze, as well as Lauren Koss. Emma Wright will do some hitting as well. On the flip side for Anoka, Sam Thomas is the setter. Caitlin DeLeon, Mary Holst, Carly Barant, Lindsay Sutton, and Lily Schulknecht round out the starting lineup for the Tornadoes.
Yeah, you know, Cardinals, you were obviously doing the one last week against Elk River, the match, and it went pretty quickly. The Cardinals are trying to avoid that here. This evening they did play Totino Grace, where Coach N said, you know, we did have a set that we were really competitive in, and we scored 22 points in the set, and so that's some of the things that they're trying to take over here into this match against Anoka. But Anoka wants to continue that win streak as well, so it should be a good one.
Well, in the match I was witness to on Tuesday night last week against Elk River, just too many unforced errors and not making the Elks work for a lot of their points, and that's a big key. As Cardinals have the first serve, able to pick it up off the net or the Cardinals and get it back over. Tornadoes will attack again with Sutton. Hintze firing back the other way off the block and out of play. A Cardinal point to start set one.
Well, the Cardinals want to come out and be aggressive. They want to counter what Anoka's doing. And they want to start off quickly.
Well, and that was one thing they really struggled with against Elk River, is winning points off serve and a very quick set and a point in the middle.
Well, and that was
Sutton with power to the floor. Oh, sorry, Schulknecht.
Yeah, Schulknecht. And that was power to the floor, no question. You know, we could sound like a broken record, but we talk about runs in volleyball, and really that's what this game is about. And, you know, Anoka here with the service looking to see if they can get their first run of this match going.
Picked up by Yang off serve. Hintze attacking. Turned quickly. Schulknecht's attack picked up again by Yang. Cardinals just able to play it all over by Frakey, but it's played a little too long out of play. And a tornado point. Attack for Hintze. Kept alive, but Tornadoes can't bring it back, and the Cardinals will break the streak and get one back for themselves.
Well, a nice shot by Hintze. She's able to put a little power on that, not allowing Anoka to return it. Just keep this match close. That's their goal.
Becca Masteler will serve for Coon Rapids. Attacking for the point is Lindsay Sutton. And gets the side out right back for Anoka.
Yeah, with Sutton and Schulknecht, they've got some size up front. And now with Bryn Hendrickson coming in, she also has a little bit of size at the front line. Not quite as tall as Sutton.
Sutton at the service line now for the Tornadoes. The 4-2 lead early in set number one. She'll add an ace and stretch the lead to 3 points. Mm-hmm. picked up by Wright. Hintze on the attack again. Therefore, it was Hovde, played right back across for Coon Rapids. They'll set up on the left side, and it's Emma Wright tipping it past the block to the floor right down the line to get the service back for the Cardinals.
Well, sometimes you don't need power to win a point, and Emma Wright did a nice job, just a little finesse up and over the front line for Anoka, falling on the floor in front of the defense.
Yang service for the Cardinals, set, goes to the left side, and the kill is good for Brent Hendrickson.
Yeah, and that, again, coming in at a good angle, not much Coon Rapids could do to get the return. We'll see it again, Brent Hendrickson doing a nice job of putting it to the floor. Makes it 6-3 Anoka.
Hintze attacking. And there was good defense there, but I don't think it made it over the net. Deep at the back is Alex Wright to play it. The attack by Masteler in the middle. They turn around with Hendrickson, and Hendrickson finds the back line to make it a 5-point edge.
Yeah, it looked like a little miscommunication at the back part of that Cardinal defense of who was going to go for that, and Anoka's going to get the point.
Holst serve picked up by Yang. Set goes for Hintze on the right side. It's blocked. She's able to pick it back up. Long pass. Cardinals able to push it over, but an illegal touch. And the streak continues for the Tornadoes. Tipped over by Fosslin, and that'll end the streak.
And again, that smart volleyball is Fosslin able, again, we talked about it. You don't need that power. If you have a little finesse and you're able just to tip it up over the front line, it's going to find the floor.
Tack in close to the net from Lindsay Roshan. Here comes Hendrickson again. It's blocked and out of play. And it'll be a 10-4 lead for the home team. Anoka's roster, not alphabetical, not numerical. I don't know if it's broken down by grade because the grades aren't displayed. Another ace, second of the first set here for Anoka.
Well, fortunately, there's not 50 players on the roster.
That's true.
So that's a good thing.
Just as I struggle a little bit early on, I'm making excuses already. Played over by Fosslin. Anoka sets up the attack with the left hand by Barant. Cardinals able to pick it up. A block at the net by Barant on the attack attempt by Emma Wright.
And that's good line play by Anoka. Again, timing that jump correctly and getting the block.
A little too much on the serve from Thomas. Side out back to Coon Rapids. Trailing 12-5.
And you look at the conference, Joe, Anoka's just really sitting right in the middle of the pack. 1-1 in the conference, 7-3 overall. Of course, Cardinals looking for their first conference victory.
One played across by Barant. Cardinals set up in the middle. Not a lot on it from Mesteler, but it stays on the Anoka side of the net, and it's a point for the Cardinals.
And this is the key for them, for Coon Rapids, is just to chip into this lead here. Hold your serve.
A little bit on, too much on the service from Emma Wright. And a side now back to Anoka. Bryn Hendrickson at the service line. Went off the basketball backboard, but Cardinals able to bring it down. Solid attack to the back corner for the point from Masteler.
Yeah, she placed it perfectly into that far back corner. you know, Mastella, I'm sure you talked about it at, against Elk River, just a freshman.
Set up and a kill for Sutton.
Oh, we saw last time Anoka had the serve, they went on a bit of a run. See what they do here. See if the Cardinals can prevent that.
Massler getting it over. Picked up and now played across by Roshan. Set goes to the middle. Loam a little late, but able to poke it over. Well, that's Frankie, rather. And the attack wide down the far sideline, and that's Coon Rapids point. Keeping this a manageable deficit.
Well, yeah, and that's exactly what they want to do. Just keep it within reason, within reach.
Bosland was there, but couldn't get off a clean pass. Good attack from Schopnik. And quickly the side out back to the Tornadoes. Add another ace to the Tornado tally. That's the third here in the first set. A 16-8 lead now. As Carly Barant returns to the service line. Left-hander floats it long. Hands it back over to the Cardinals.
Oh, trailing by seven. Again, here's your opportunity. Anoka's letting them get their opportunities here by giving service back.
In the middle of Schopnik, picked up by Masteler. Wright tipping it over the defense. Tornado's able to scrabble and pick it up. Sutton will get the kill on the far side. Just no chance for Fosslin on that one. Sutton on the serve. And another ace.
Oh, Anoka's starting to build that lead back up.
Took a little something off of that one. Yang there to pick it up. The attack is denied. Oh. Tipped back across by Schopnik, but she stepped.
Was she on the net?
Or she went over the net.
That's what I thought.
So it'll be a Cardinal point.
18-10 in favor of Anoka.
Schopnik attacking in the middle. Fosslin's there for it. Quick attack from Hintze. Hendrickson is stuffed by Hintze. In the middle, played back. Another strong play at the net from Schopnik, using that extra height to get up and tip it away from the Cardinals to the floor.
Yeah, again, they've got two, perhaps three athletes that with some size that they keep in at all times, power at the net.
Pulse at the service line. She was there for their biggest run. Emma Wright on the attack. Tornadoes pick it up. Short set pushed across by Barant. Cardinals come back with Hintze. Here comes Hendrickson. Wright sends it back across. Tornadoes will set up. And that one just a little too tight to the net. A missed pass gives the side out back to Coon Rapids. Hintze had a little English on that. Good play at the net there by Lauren Cost to get up and tip it back down, and the Tornadoes are not able to recover.
Now, you know, and again, the Cardinals just have to be competitive, keep it competitive.
Yeah. the floor for Hendrickson.
Again, they, you know, they have that power. They have Hendrickson, they have Schoepneck.
Sutton.
Those three players in general, strong on the front line.
Samantha Thomas is gonna get another ace. Fifth of the set for Anoka. It's 21 to 12, excuse me. Attacked by Koss, turned right back over, pushed over by Foss. Tornadoes just push it and it ends up in the back corner. It was good placement from Samantha Thomas.
Yeah, it really was. I thought at first it was gonna go out, but just way to find that back corner. Just hits that line.
Makes it a 10-point lead late in the first set. Right attack into the net, got a little too much on top of it. Thomas will put another ace on the board and take us to set point. Thomas into the top of the net. The Cardinals will get another chance. Got to play mistake free for 9 points.
You really
do.
Yeah, no pressure.
No pressure.
Yeah, well, you know, they just want to be able to go on that run now that they haven't been able to do.
Oh, that's a good start, Emma Wright. Puts up the first ace of the set for the Cardinals. Pauline had to go down to the floor for that one. Big attack from Barrant. Played across by Fossling, and Anoka not able to save it.
Well, the Cardinals won't go away.
Back within single digits.
Yep. Again, this is their run. This is where they have to go on a mighty run to stay in this first set.
Yep. Add another ace. Hendrickson will put an end to it with her fourth or fifth kill of that first set. Anoka Tornadoes win at 25-16. We'll take a break. Be back with more from Anoka High School after this. You're watching live high school volleyball on CTN. Coon Rapids able to hang with the Tornadoes for much of that first half, then able to get a good little spurt right at the end to avoid early termination, but as it was, just too much power for the Anoka Tornadoes. 12 kills and 5 aces in that set, Yund, officially.
Of course. Well, and that's what the Cardinals need to do here in set number two, is just take some of that positive that they were able to get in set one and put a little more emphasis on that as they continue on. They certainly don't want to fall behind 2-0. So this is an important set for them. They have to come out and they have to be aggressive and they have to try and take an early lead, I believe.
Well, they were able to do that. They had the first point of the match.
Yep. but they need to go on an early run, I think.
I think that's the big key, as I had mentioned, just the ability to score on your service is essential to getting those runs that lead to victory. It's awfully hard to win 1 point at a time.
Yeah, no question about it.
Holst awaits and now serves to get the second set underway. Hintze on the attack, and she will start the Cardinals out in front for the second straight set.
Yep, there's that first point.
Becca Mastler at the service line puts way too much on it.
Yeah.
And back to Anoka.
And not able to start that run. And the dangerous part is we've seen Anoka go on several.
Brandt serving, picked up by Alex Wright. Set goes to Emma Wright on the attack. Near the back line to pick it up was DeLeon. The attack by Sutton turned around by Frakey. Sutton will tip it past her this time. Emma Wright there to pick it up. Here comes Hintze on the hit. Took a little something off it, found the soft part of the zone, and put the Cardinals back in front.
Yeah, and again, you don't have to be overly aggressive to win a point. Look at, she just, as you mentioned, just enough off of it to go up over that front line, hit the floor.
Called on the set will give the Cardinals a freebie and a 3-1 lead.
Yeah, and again, this is what they need. They need that early lead, just really to give them some confidence.
DeLeon near the back line. Attack in the middle for Schopnik, picked up by Yang, pushed across by Fosslin. Good block there, but the Tornado is able to pick it up, send it across, however, out of play. And the Cardinals' lead grows to 4-1. And that's something in one of my earlier conversations, and a great little help from the net. There's no let serves in volleyball.
Nope. And you'll take it. The net is definitely, well, can be your friend, and in that case, it certainly was to the Cardinals.
But in talking to Coach Enns earlier in the season, Carey called against the Cardinals. He talked about their confidence level in getting them into position to then learn how to play with the lead.
Yep.
Team that has not led much, much less won much over the last few seasons, and the mindset and the difference in strategy when you have the lead and having the confidence to play there.
Well, and you said it, confidence, and that's really the key word. Now they have the lead. Let's see how they build upon that and play with that confidence.
Ellie Hintze, her third kill of this first set, and that was right in the corner. Perfectly placed on the service from Hintze, and it's a 5-point edge for Coon Rapids.
She needs a volleyball. Again, watch it here, just perfect placed right in that far back corner.
Tag from Hendrickson. And somebody on the Cardinals. Stepped across. Sure. What rule was violated there, but it's a side out to the Tornadoes.
We'll see it here.
One of them, oh yeah.
Over the line.
Yeah, Fosslin stepped over.
Yeah.
Fosslin tipping it across, a diving attempt at the save by Jindra, but After making the foot fault, smart play by Fosslin to get the ball right back.
Really, really smart play. Not much Anoka could do to return that one. It's an 8-3 lead.
It's a little more height needed to get the tape effect that Yang worked with. Wow. Sometimes things just work for you. That one bounced off the top of the net. Anoka thought it was going out. It landed right on the line. 9-4 lead. Haas at the service line. Haas will pick this one up. Set goes to Frankie through a block into the floor.
Now there, Carl's able to play with that lead and increase it. Now lead up to 6, 10-4.
Attack by Hendrickson. Therefore it was Koss. Great defense at the net by Mara Bowler. And that will get the point for the Tornadoes.
Cardinals called timeout. I didn't see who called it. Nonetheless, both teams able to talk a little strategy here with Anoka trailing by 5 and halves the serve. Winning that first set, would certainly like to go on a run here. They want to make it a quick night, I'm sure.
Well, the Cardinals want to make sure right here and now that it will not be a sweep by evening things up here.
I love our new graphics. Josh Udvig just made this today. This is hot off the press. You can see everything that we do on YouTube. Hey, there you are. It's Joe Young.
And more importantly, there is Shapiro. And that's what it's all about,
it
the
is.
Fans.
Oh, yeah.
The Cardinal
absolutely.
Faithful.
Absolutely.
Our side of it, anyhow. But
yep.
Jordan Rylance does a very nice job.
Yes, she does.
Highlighting things within the community. Find myself thoroughly entranced with every new episode. So the Tornadoes get the side out the service. And they trail here 5-10. In the second set, they won the first 25-16. Attacked by Frakey, nice sliding save. Crossed by Bowler. And an Anoka foot foul will give the point back to the Cardinals. Coach Enns was jumping up and down on the sideline, make sure the referee is seeing both sides when the feet come across.
He quickly pointed towards the Cardinals side. That is our point. And it definitely was. We'll see it again. There you can see it right there over the line.
Pushed over by Bowler. Big attack by Mastler. Back the other way. Sutton finds the back corner. The line judge just ruled out. The Cardinals are pointing to the line judge who indicated out.
Well, they're not reversing it. It was in.
Mastler attacking again. Good save by Holt to keep things going. Back set to Hintze. Needed some angle on it. Found the angle and found the floor.
Yeah, she really did. And Anoka slow to react on that point. Anoka doesn't look like the same team that they did in that first set. They're not able to set up.
Yund officially, they just have the one kill. And that was the one we just saw from Sutton. Yep. The controversial.
Now our official is talking to Coach Enns.
Back line. Got a wet spot on the floor. We got to get the towel out there. Dry it up, keep it safe. Good job done by Sophia Frakey.
Yep. These players do it all.
Masteler is serving. The attack right through the middle for Barant. Get Anoka the point and the service back at 12-7.
And then, you know, if you're Anoka, obviously just keeping this thing close is important. Now down by five.
A shoe on the other foot.
Yep.
Almost
yep.
an identical situation to what we had in the first. Nice save by Alex Wright. The attack by Hintze. Sutton will come back the other way and put it to the floor.
That time Sutton did a nice job of, she didn't need the power on that one. She put the finesse with it, able to find the floor. 12-8, Coon Rapids. Again, just found that all that room in the back court.
Passes back a little far. Sutton got a little anxious and reached across. Side out and service back to the Cardinals. Allison Yang will head to the service line. Played over by Sutton. Cardinals set up for Masteler and she gets the point.
And a beautiful set. Very aggressive on that
hit. That was Emma Wright.
Very aggressive on the kill. Makes it 14-8. Lead back to six.
Schultnecht plays it too long. 7-point lead, timeout Anoka.
Yeah, and you know, really, this is the kind of set that Coach Jens wants to see from his squad. You know, they started with the lead and they've been able to build upon it. I know you didn't see that in the game that you did, and we certainly didn't see that in the first set.
And these next couple of points out of this timeout will be big for both squads. For Anoka, an opportunity to keep this one from getting out of hand. For the Cardinals, an opportunity to maybe push it out of reach.
Well, don't push your Twitter out of reach. Make sure you follow us if you want to see everything that's going on in Coon Rapids. Just make sure you follow us.
Howie Shapiro, the Segway champion of all time. No,
I've learned from the best, Joe Yutt.
I think they're checking on Howie's Twitter feed. Now there'd be more excitement if it was Howie's Twitter feed.
Yeah.
That looks like the disappointment that they find the last tweet from Joe Yutt was 4 years ago.
And his account's been locked up.
Tag from Sutton for Anoka, picked up by Alex Wright. The set goes to Hintze. The Cardinals into the net. And that's a big point, as we talked about. Out of the timeout, you always want to score that first point, stop the run on the other side of the net. That part has been accomplished by the Tornadoes. Now see if they can get a little run and cut this lead even further. Hintze, good, strong attack, picked up, though. And the Tornadoes are able to play it back across. Set will go to Emma Wright. Therefore, it was Hoity. Attacked by Hendrickson. The Cardinals pick it up. Hintze. Pushed over by Thomas. Good volley going. Cardinals got a little sloppy, and that's four passes.
Can't do that.
Nope.
That's what I'm told. I'll cut the lead to five.
Hintze tips it over. Nice save by Schultnecht. Hendrickson on the attack, picked up by Wright. Here's Emma Wright. And that's going to be a kill. Holst had that one get her right in the chest.
See it there, just a, you know, again with some power, not able to control that one.
Poked over by Thomas, saved by the Cardinals. Set up for Hendrickson, she's stuffed. And the Cardinal lead grows to 7. First block of the evening for the Cardinals. Back in the middle by Schulknecht. The Cardinals can't recover. And the side out to the Tornadoes.
Well, Cardinals trying to put this one out of reach, but Anoka's going to do their best to say, yeah, we're not going to have that in our house. Trailing by 6 with the serve.
Lily Schulknecht on the serve. Set for Cossin, just missed wide. Played back over by Hendrickson. The attack by Wright is a good one. And that's huge for the Cardinals. Quick responses when they do give up points.
And that's exactly what I was going to say.
Not allow any long streaks on the other side.
It's a very powerful kill. Nothing that Noah could do to return that one right in front of kind of that softer spot on the floor.
Hendrickson played that one into the net. Lead back to 7. Emma Wright, too much on the serve, gives it right back, 19-13.
Matt, those are the things that hurt you when you've got this kind of a lead and you have the serve. You certainly don't want to beat yourself by putting the serve out of bounds.
Samantha Thomas awaits to serve for the Tornadoes. Picked up by Shevchuk. Attack and a good kill for Becca Masteler.
Well, good. Cardinals doing all that they need to do to continue to play with this lead. And show that if they can hold on and even this thing up, that takes a lot of confidence into the next set.
Grant's attack is picked up. Loam from midcourt. That's a home run in her other shot.
At least it's to the wall. There it is, all the way to the wall in the gap.
Not what she was looking for.
Still a healthy 7-point lead for Coon Rapids.
6.
6-point lead for Coon Rapids. I was looking at that before they changed it at our scoreboard.
I love how you say that.
I know. Then I had to. I know.
If
people can see, that's why I corrected it. I was doing it for your purpose, Joe, so you can see what I was talking about.
Sutton blows it into the net. 21-14. Now it's a 7-point lead.
Yep. I knew it was going to happen. I knew it was going to get to 7.
Coon Rapids just 4 points away from evening this at a set apiece. Tack is right on the back line. A good kill for Mara Bowler.
Well, as you mentioned earlier,
unofficially the 3rd kill of this second set for Anoka.
You said the Cardinals have responded well. When they lose a point, they've been able to come back and gain a point.
Tipped over by Fosslin. This time it doesn't trick him. Masteler plays it over. Attacked by Barant at a point for the Tornadoes. Full serves. Quick turn by the Cardinals. And the Tornadoes not able to recover. 22-16. Masteler returns to the service line.
Well, the Cardinals can taste it. They're 2 points away. Timeout Anoka. They're going to talk about things trailing 23-16 after winning that first set, hoping to come into the second set and make it a quick night for their squad. But Coon Rapids is not going to let that happen. Hey, you know what? We actually did Sports Night on Monday this week.
We did do Sports Night on a Monday, and it was all due to the weather. We were all set to do some tennis yesterday against St. Francis. That was rained out. And so we put Sports Night on the air on a Monday night for once. And we're here tonight.
There we are. There we are tonight. Neil Hennon did a little scrambling to get this changed.
We did intend to be on the Sports Night set tonight.
We did.
Instead, here we are in the nice, warm, toasty confines of Anoka.
Well, they did move the fan on us, so it's kind of, we're getting a little bit of a breeze here. Right there to your left, that way. See, I knew I'd be able to point eventually. People could see what I was doing.
I thought all the fans
here
were just Shapiro
here
fans. Aha! Everywhere we go, we find Shapiro fans. And he doesn't have to keep cool. He was born that way.
That's right.
I was born with sunglasses on. But it allows us
to banter a little bit. Talk about Sports Night.
Another dancing monkey opportunity for us. Entertain us. The sports have paused.
Well, Coach DJ always likes us to keep him entertained, so we got to do our best just for him. Not sure he's watching tonight, but.
That is a big service ace right there that will make it set point Coon Rapids. That is definitely not what you wanted coming out of that timeout, and Masteler will serve for the set. Tornado's able to pick it up. Big attack in the middle. Nice save by Masteler. Wright tips it over with the left hand. Thomas keeps it alive. Brandt attacking. Therefore, it is Fossil and just plays it back over. Sutton attacks, and therefore it was once again a huge kill for Emma Wright to the back line. And that will give the Cardinals the 25-16 win. Exact same score in reverse. And we're all tied up at one set apiece. Third set coming up next on CTN.
Looking for a new home? Come to Coon Rapids. Down payment assistance is available from the Mortgage Assistance Foundation when you purchase your new home with an FHA 203K mortgage. Any single-family home in need of renovation or rehab can qualify. Find out more today. Call 763-767-6422 or visit the city's website.
We love our new home.
Coon Rapids came out not going to go down easily. They were the ones to set the tempo, bring the pressure at the home team at Anoka Tornadoes. They got the lead early and they kept it there. They were never able to really sit back and relax. Nope. The lead was not that big, but they were able to keep themselves out front by 4, 5, 6 points throughout the majority of the second set. And we have the exact same score we had in set one, except in reverse. Cardinals victorious 25-16.
11 kills for Coon Rapids, and that was obviously their key. And what confidence this brings to the Cardinals. You know, after dropping that first set, it's kind of like, here we go again. And they were really able to turn their game around. And I thought Anoka didn't look like the same team that they did in that first set. I think Coon Rapids became the aggressor, and that's what they need to do here in set number three, as they want to see if they can actually take the lead.
Had very slow starts to the sets. And of course, the one long pause in the middle of set number two.
Now we're looking at
we're but there's no time limit.
No,
so
no.
Take your time. Make sure everybody's in the right place.
It could go on all night.
Nah, I don't know about that. Coon Rapids will serve to start the third. Sutton will just have to pass it over for the Cardinals. Frankie attacking in the middle and a big block by Lindsay Roshan.
Now, first time Coon Rapids won the first point both sets so far. This time, Anoka winning the first point. We'll see where that leads them.
A little miscommunication and an ace for the Tornadoes. This is not how you want to start.
No.
After evening the score.
No.
Back-to-back aces, and you know, we talk about one of the keys for Coach Enns is making opponents work for points.
Yep.
And that starts on the receive. Good clean passing. Big defense by Hintze at the net. Hintze attacking now and too long. And a very quick 4-0 lead for Anoka here in the third set. If they can play this back over, which they do.
That's a great.
Inbounds. That went up and over. And, Cardo thought that was going out instead right at the back line. And a 5-0.
Take another look at that. That's out. I don't think that hit the
You're
line.
You're not a homer at all.
Well, no, I'm just saying.
Got a little help from the net and get another ace.
I'm just saying, I'm just calling it. It looked like it hit the back of the line. A homer or not homer?
Well, you say it hit the back of the line. This was my question right here was, how far do you let it go before calling a timeout?
Right.
This, I believe, is the first time the Cardinals have had to call a timeout
right.
all evening. But certainly not the start you want after you've come back to even things up in a six-point hole.
Whether you like that last call or you didn't, we'll just make sure you like us on Facebook, CTN. CoonRapids.com, Facebook. Please like us. We haven't gotten a new like in a
she's
long
calling
time.
She's calling right now on a telemarketing scheme is not the right word, campaign.
A Ponzi scheme? Is that what you were going to say?
A
campaign to get us more likes?
Yeah, that's right.
All right.
Hey, go to CTN Coon
Rapids. Joe Yun's here.
Like the Facebook page.
Joe Yun's here in the house. Come on, like their page. Maybe he'll say my name on TV.
Just thinking for every 50 likes you bring to our page, you get a free pizza? Maybe? I don't know.
I don't know. Do we have the power to grant that?
Not really.
But we could do it anyway.
We can say it. That is ace number four in this set, this streak to start set number three. And a lazy pass and a kill for Sutton right down the line, and it's 8-0.
Again, she's able to get a piece of that line. And Anoka has jumped out to that 8-0 lead. Oh, not there.
Streak only comes to an end with a bad serve by Thompson. Cardinals get their first opportunity since the opening serve of the set. Masteller at the line and a great serve. It just kind of died as it got over. A diving attempt made by Bowler, but she comes up empty. Sutton to the back corner will get the service back for the Tornadoes.
They hold that 7-2, an early 7-2 lead here. Set number three.
Cardinals wisely let that one go, and the service by Sutton is too long. Caitlin DeLeon comes in for Anoka as Allison Yang takes over the service line for the Cardinals. Holst, quick set in the middle, pushed over by Roshan. Attack coming from right, and she gets the kill.
Again, they just want to be patient, one point at a time, and then cut into this lead.
A little too much on it for Bowler. She really had to reach back. That set was a little bit behind her. Cardinals able to get the lead back to four. Kind of tipped over by Thompson, went off of Cardinal and found the floor.
No, I say Cardinal point.
She touched the net?
She must have. That's all I can think of.
That cake.
Oh, I always think of cake. Are you kidding? I tried to legally change my middle name to Cake.
Roshan's attack, and Colonel tried to dump it back over, but unable to do so, and a side out for the Tornadoes with a 10-6 lead. Right, attacking big block is there for Shocknecht.
Cardinals cut the lead to three.
Oh, they got through.
They did. Yep.
And now an ace. And it's a 2-point lead. Didn't see a little too much on it.
Yeah, smartly they let that one go out of bounds.
But definitely back within a reasonable amount.
No question.
Just a 3-point deficit.
Well, they started off
once eight.
Yep. No question.
Right tips it over the defense, picked up by Barant. Attack on the far side by Bowler. Cardinals able to recover quickly. Wright tips it through the block attempt and to the floor. It's a big point for the Cardinals. Again, when they did give the side out up, it was a good volley going, and then Wright able to end it, just pushing it across.
Yeah, you know, as you mentioned, Shoknik got a little bit of a piece of it, but not enough to be able to turn it.
Pushed over by Sam Lowe. Attack in the middle by Shoknik, blocked by Koss. Pushing it over is Bowler. Lowe on the attack. She'll go to the back line where it's picked up by DeLeon. Attack for Shoknik didn't work. Cardinals just have to pass it across here. Shoknik in the middle again. Good save by Lohm. Pushed over by Bowler once more. Koss with the attack. Shoknik pushes it over. Masteller is wide. And after the long volley, the point to the Tornadoes at 12-9 edge.
It was a nice volley. Both teams doing what they could to try and win that point.
Keely Boleen at the service line. Her team a 3-point lead. We're all tied at a set apiece. That's a big ace. still are attacking. Nice save by Holst. Thompson will push it across for Anoka. Set goes to Mastler. Big block by Schultnick. We'll get the Tornadoes the point.
Makes it 14-9. Anoka trying to develop a little bit of a run here again like they did to start this set.
Back is into the net. Tornadoes starting to build the lead again. They had it as high as 8 to start this third set. In the middle, Schultnick will get the kill.
We'll see it again. And again, not a lot of power, but direction was the key there as she's able to direct it to that middle line.
Too much power on the service by Boleen, and the side up back to the Cardinals at 16-10. Quick set, Schultnick pushes it across, saved by Fosslin, attacked by Messler, and that's into the net.
Well, not able to hold their serve, just giving it now back to Anoka with a 7-point lead.
Holst serves it wide and exchanging 3 points. Tornadoes would be happy to do that. Maybe not happy, but be willing to do that the rest of the way. Weak pass, and Hintze tried to make him pay. The Tornadoes able to recover. Sutton on the attack. Cardinals pick it up. Hintze attacking. That's blocked. No, she hit it into the net.
Yep.
And another ace back to an 8-point lead at 19-11. Timeout, Coon Rapids.
Yeah, and a good timeout by Coach Ennis as he sees his squad falling behind by 8, 19-11. And you know, we're approaching that mark where they have to play mistake-free volleyball if they want to stay in this set.
And you do not want to be in an elimination. One of these two teams obviously will be facing elimination in the fourth set.
Correct.
You would certainly like to not be that one.
No question about it.
See, our stuff's so good on YouTube, our guys are watching it while they're doing it. That's how good our people are.
Well, I heard that they'd really like to hear what you have to say. So they're watching our broadcast, listening to the analogy that you bring to this.
I'm glad that your contract makes you say such things. When we all know those headsets could be carrying the audio, but it has been requested over and over and over again that the program audio does not have to be heard.
Correct.
By our crew. And they are all much happier people for it. Hintze attacking, blocked in the middle by Barrant. Tornado's able to recover, get it across. Hintze had to backpedal for that one. Thompson picks it up. Barrant attacking. Hintze goes to the floor for it. Now Hintze will just push it across. Sutton waiting, blocked by Hintze. That set a little too far, and that went around the net, or around the post.
Yep.
And that'll be a Cardinal point. They needed that one coming out of the timeout.
They did, no question about it. They wanted to gain that service back.
And now Mastler set to serve for the Cardinals. Yang will just pass it across. In the middle, the attack by Roshan. Hensie had to go sidewise to get ways to get to it, but attacked. Sutton's attack saved momentarily by Yang, but Cardinals can't keep it off the floor.
No, good hustle by Yang to reach out for that. Makes it 20 to 12.
And they give the point right back.
Yeah, and you hurt yourself when you lose service like that. It keeps Coon Rapids with the opportunity, down by 7.
Weak pass, Cardinals pick it up. Set comes back to right. She's blocked by Roshan in the middle. Hensie attacking from the right side now. Tornado's able to pick it up. Long set. Had to back up and just play it over with Bowler. Bracky's attack was just pushed right back. Right is blocked. Cardinals set up again. Fracky will play it over. Brandt will put an end to it with the big left hand.
Again, able to get the advantage. A nice set to her, and she's able to get the point. Makes it 21-13.
Roshan will add the ace, number 7 of this set for the Tornadoes.
As they inch ever closer to taking the lead.
It's almost a third of their points have come off ace. Now more than a third of their points have come off of an ace, and they're 2 points away from a 2-1 lead. Right attacking. Bryant back the other way, gets the kill, and it'll be set point for Anoka.
Again, just the power there, and Cardinals couldn't recover.
Cardinals able to get it across, but out of play, and the Tornadoes will take the 2-1 lead with a 25-13 win in the third set. We will take a break and be back with the fourth. You're watching live high school volleyball on CTN.
Hey Rover, come on over to the Coon Rapids Love My Pet Fair coming up on Saturday, September 23rd. There's lots of fun things to see and do. There'll be a costume contest for pets, dog training demonstrations, paw art, even a pet parade for you and your pet to take part in. Meet local vendors who have products and services that can help you and your pet. It's the Coon Rapids Love My Pet Fair, Saturday, September 23rd, from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Riverview Park in Coon Rapids. See you there.
Third set started with one of the longest streaks we've seen all night for either squad. The Tornadoes to an 8-0 lead before the Cardinals cracked the scoreboard. A lot of weird points, a lot of long volleys that ended with miscues rather than clean attacks. But in the end, the Tornadoes come away with a 25-13 win and now have that big 2-1 edge going to the fourth set.
Yeah, I mean, again, 5 kills for Anoka in that, but helping themselves by getting out to an 8-0 lead. But the key for that particular set is 8 aces for the Tornadoes.
And a lot of that is due to Cardinal mistakes as far as placement and handling. You know, serve receives so crucial, and obviously something they did not do well in set number 3. And they will need to try and clean it up here if they hope to force a 5th and final.
Let's see, I'm going to like CTN's page. There we go.
That's all it takes.
That's all it takes.
That's all it takes.
Hey, it's nothing but a thing.
Just 2 seconds out of your day. You can do it right between sets while you're coaching volleyball.
He did.
As Coach Enns did. Coach Fenwick, a longtime fan. He's liked our page for
absolutely.
For years and years.
At least years and years. Could be even more than that.
Coach N's just finding out these last couple of weeks just how much he does like CTN. He just didn't know it until now. Mostly for Shapiro.
Yeah, oh yeah, sure.
We're back to the Dancing Monkey Show to start the set. And burn up a little bit of time.
There we go. We're getting ready. Anoka's gonna start it off.
Well, both teams wanted to start with the serve. It doesn't usually work that way.
They can't both start with a serve.
It'd be fun if they could.
Wouldn't it? Just use two balls.
Yeah, just to see how things would work out in the end.
Think of
how much faster the game would go. Checking the rotation, make sure the substitutions are all legal. Right people in the right places.
All right, we're ready to go.
Right numbers on the jerseys, on the floor. And we're all good. We did not award a point for something done improperly. And the fourth set underway. Fracky on the attack.
Good thing we
did not get it over the net.
It's a good thing we don't lose points for things done improperly, because we'd be in the hole every week.
We being the CTN broadcaster.
Just you and I in general.
Getting things wrong, it's what we're good at.
Everybody else here does a great job. It's just you and I sometimes that are a little questionable.
Kinsey on the attack will get the kill and even the score at one apiece.
And that's the key to this is see if they can go on a run, but keep it close regardless. If you fall behind, keep it close.
Masteler serving, and she'll serve up an ace. Well, the first set, the Tornadoes won 25-16.
Yep.
Second set, the Cardinals won 25-16. And it was almost a complete role reversal between sets one and two. Now, Tornadoes won set three, 25-13. Will we see a similar switcheroo here in the fourth?
A switcheroo.
It's a technical term.
It must be a volleyball term. It's the old switcheroo.
Maybe perhaps, as I was saying, Cardinals win this one 25-13 and force a fifth and final. Tornadoes able to pick that up near the back line. Sutton on the attack. Alex right there for the save, but in too tight to the net. Cardinals can't control. And the Tornadoes take the lead 2-3. Hendrickson at the service line. Weak pass, and Roshan tried to take advantage. Cardinals just have to play it back over. Sutton on the attack, put a little too much angle on it. And it's out of bounds down the sideline. Set goes to Hintze. Hintze tried to get it around the block and put it into the net instead.
Yeah, just a miss hit on her behalf.
Turned right back around.
And that's what they want to do, play point for point. But trailing by a point here, they've got an opportunity to, keep this one close. Unfortunately, that's
that
gonna
one
go
didn't
out.
Miss by nope. Much down the line. But yeah, the unforced errors are the big key. The team that is better at limiting the freebie points. Typically is the team that comes away with the victory. Thank you, Neil Hennon.
Yeah, he was reading the world book and said the team that scores the most points usually wins. Usually wins.
Usually. Right on the attack. It's saved by Holst. But no one there to receive it. And it'll stay a one-point game. Peyton Shevchuk will check in and head to the service line for the Cardinals. And she will serve up an ace that ties us at six.
Well, winning that second set did a lot for Coon Rapids in terms of confidence. Now they know they have an opportunity here to try and tie it up again.
Short neck, yep. Able to poke that one to the floor.
Just finds that little soft spot. Don't need much. Just needed to hit the floor.
Yang passes it across. Set goes to Shoknik. Taps it over the defensive cost. Attacking is Masteler, and a carry by the Tornadoes. Evens the score again at 7-all.
Well, Cardinals are definitely not going to go away in this one. They're playing point for point.
Good job by Fosslin to get up there and make them pay for the weak serve return. Lauren Koss waits to serve. Cardinals with the lead, 8-7. Attack by Shoknik. Shevchuk is there. Fosslin thought she had it, just didn't quite get it over the net. Tried to catch him by surprise. That was the Cardinals' first lead of this third set. Tornadoes trying to close it out. Cardinals trying to force a fifth and final. And a bad touch by the Cardinals. Miscommunication, and the Cardinals, that's not how they wanted that one to work. They obviously moved in rotation and they were trying to set something up.
Yep.
Some lines got crossed, and we'll call a timeout.
Well, and a good timeout by Coach Jens again. 10-8 in favor of Anoka. The Cardinals know they have to, if they want to stay alive in this one, they have to become victorious here. And so before, it's a manageable 2-point opportunity. Just again, keep it, try and keep it close.
YouTube parade. CTN Studios is on
homecoming parade YouTube. Tomorrow.
Can you believe it?
I can believe it, actually.
You can't really like our YouTube page, can you? Follow it.
Well, you can in your heart.
I love it in my heart.
I do. Do in mine as well, in my mind.
So as always, points out of timeouts are big. As we get later in this match, they become that much more critical. Holst serving, Loam there to pick it up for the Cardinals. Masteler on the attack, and just too much on that.
A little bit of too much mustard on that one.
Remember, just a freshman.
Right.
She will be very dangerous as years go on.
Yes.
Already a nice volleyball player. Fosslin was calling that one went into the net and wasn't blocked, but not the way the referee saw it. Tornado's able to play it across. Therefore, it is Masteler. Sloan will push it over. Holst pick it up. Roshan gets it through the defense and ends the rally in the Tornado's favor.
I'll give him a 4-point lead at 12-8. Again, watch it just gonna go past. Got tipped up at the front line. That was Frakey. Got a piece of it.
Roshan attacking and getting another kill. Largest lead either way here in this fourth set. Tornadoes up 5. They try and close it out. Masteler will just pass it across. Roshan to the back corner, and she found it.
Well, the defense playing in, and she's able to put enough loft on it to find that back corner. That was pretty.
Put a little English on the serve. Nearly caught the Cardinals sleeping, and then the attack by Frakey was into the top of the net.
And Anoka starting to open up their lead.
Attacking is Hendrickson. She'll get the kill from the left side.
Yeah, it looks a little more like that first set for Anoka where they were dominant at the front line.
Frakey able to get it through the block, get the kill and the streak.
Well, they needed it.
The Cardinals desperately needed that side out. You are correct. Paige Fonslin at the service line for the Cardinals. Hendrickson attacking, and she'll get another kill. And the serve is right back to the Tornadoes.
See it there, just enough on it. Little fingertips at the line for Coon Rapids.
Set for Hintze. She's blocked but able to pick it right back up. Yang will play it across for the Cardinals. Set goes to Barant, and she finds the corner.
Yeah, a good thought there is that she finds that back corner. Continue this progression toward the victory, hopefully the victory they hope anyway. And then a service into the net.
This is a big service for the Cardinals right here, trailing by 8.
Yep. Really big.
And Becca Masteler will take you over at the service line. The next service is even bigger for the Cardinals. That's the one that's really
that's the
big
one. That's really big. 19-10 now in favor of the Tornadoes.
Bryn Hendrickson at the service line. She's had a really nice match for the Tornadoes. Picked up by Alex Wright. Yang on the attack. You don't see that very often, but she got the job done. Gets the kill, gets the ball back for the Cardinals.
Yeah, just a good job by Yang. Hit that with some authority.
One of the 4 seniors on the roster is Allison Yang, of course, the team's libero. Not many attacks designed for the libero. Brandt's attack is long. Wright just has to pass it over. Diving save by Holst in the middle. Roshan. Nice save by Fosslin, and she had to roll over Yang. Tipped across by Fracky. Nice save by Sutton. But the Tornadoes cannot recover. Cardinals starting to chip away.
Well, and that's what they need to do. There you see this.
Told you it was that next service.
It was. You were right.
Important. Barant's attack picked up by Yang. Hincy cross. Barant is there. And a carry by the Tornadoes.
Cardinals able to drop that lead to five. Yeah.
Their lead has been cut, as you mentioned, to 5 points. Coach Fenwick wants to stop the momentum and talk things over a little bit.
Which makes sense. You know, they're in the driver's seat at this point, up 19-4 or 14. And, you know, just wants to make sure that they're on the same page. And again, continue to attack the way they were earlier to build this lead.
Yang trying to keep her rhythm going. Big attack by Sutton. Nice save. But Barant is there as it got to the net. Puts it right back to the floor. Yeah. That's a big point out of the timeout.
Huge point. Not much the Cardinals could do there on that, to get that point. That was hit with some authority.
Right. Avoids the defense. And a quick answer for the Cardinals.
Again, just a soft little shot over the net to gain the point.
Oh. A little trickery on Thompson's part. Tried to just tip it over, but she's called for the carry.
Cardinals just being patient. They've cut into this lead, cut by three. They're not ready for their evening to be over.
Gabrielle Neseth, the service line for the Cardinals. And she'll pick up an ace. It's down to a 2-point deficit. If you're looking for Neseth, she's on the JV roster as number 30. Or 20, sorry.
20.
Played that one into the net, unfortunately. End the streak in Anoka. And now this is kind of a big service for Anoka.
Yes, it is.
They have to be able to try and stretch that lead back out and just finish things off, not let the Cardinals hang around, because if this were to go to a fifth set, the team that won the fourth set is usually the team favored, because they're going to bring in a little more momentum. Right on the attack. Tornadoes picking it up. Nice save by Thompson. Now played across. Fosslin tips it over. The Cardinals get the point. And again, get it right back. So huge for them to be able to get quick side outs.
Oh, no question. You know, that one was just misplayed by Barant for Anoka. And she was definitely upset with herself. And Cardinals, you know, Dow just within two, staying alive here in the fourth set.
Shevchuk service. And Thompson touches it over, gets the Cardinals off guard, and a 22-19 lead. Mm-hmm. Lowell made the diving attempt but couldn't come up with it. Rachel Schmidt serving now for Anoka. Big kill for Maskell here to keep the Cardinals alive. Coon Rapids trying to force a fifth and final. They trail the Tornadoes 22-20 here late in the fourth set. And now Lauren Koss at the service line, another one of the four seniors on the roster. And she'll get an ace. Wow. It's a one-point contest.
Nobody there for Anoka. I think it's a little wet out there. I think, if I'm not mistaken, I think Samantha Thomas slipped trying to attempt to go over and cover that.
In the middle of the kill for Schultnecht. Three-21, the Tornadoes lead. Cardinals take timeout. Anoka just 2 points away from a victory, but the Cardinals just 4 points from pushing this to a fifth and final contest.
And you know, Coach Fenwick too, on the other hand, says, you know, we're within 2 points of calling it an evening, getting a victory, moving to 8-3. The Cardinals, if they have anything to say about that, will try and push it to that fifth and deciding set.
Holst ready to serve. A 23-21 lead picked up by Lohm. The attack coming from Masteller. Tornadoes turn it quickly. Hendrickson on the attack. Yang is there to dig it out. Masteller takes a little something off. It's picked up by the Tornadoes. Hendrickson attacking again. Yang got it, but the Cardinals can't keep it up, and it's going to be match point for the Tornadoes.
Mary Holst, see if she can get this victory with her service.
Set, Yang from midcourt. Tornadoes ready for it. Hendrickson battled it through the block, picked up by Lohm. Here's Yang again. Picked up by Holst, but back into the net. The Cardinals still alive. They get the service down at 24-22.
Chip in the chair.
Played across by Hendrickson. Back set, Hintze through the block. It's a 1 point contest.
And nip and tuck here, no question.
Some help from the net. Nice save. Thompson pushed it across. Cardinals carry.
Yeah.
And that's game.
A tough way. That is such a tough way to lose a match.
Oh. Cardinals were making a nice run, but the carry called. And the Tornadoes, who were on their heels there. The Cardinals had a good little run going. But Cardinals' mistake. And the Tornadoes survive with the 25-23 win.
You know, and I think if you asked Coach Enns what they take out of this match, even though they did not win, is the fact that they played tough and they gave Anoka all they could handle.
Yeah, and they did, and they battled back after being heartily outplayed in the first set. They came back and did the same thing to Anoka in the second.
Yep, they did.
And then, you know, after they fell behind relatively big early in set number four, they came back and they made it exciting at the end. nearly forcing it into extra points.
Yeah, would they have rather have got the W? Of course. But the fact that they were able to keep it as close as they did and keep the pressure on Anoka all evening long, that's a nice thing to take out of it to your next match.
Well, our next match will be on the gridiron. It's football and it's homecoming. Ooh. As the Cardinals host the 3-0 Irondale Knights. Join us for live coverage on Friday night starting at 7 o'clock next Tuesday. As of right now, we're scheduled to do volleyball. With the shuffling of the schedules, that may change. We've done 2 in a row. Will it be 3 in a row? Tune in next week on Tuesday at 7 o'clock to find out.
It's a mystery.
And then on Friday the 29th, the Cardinal football team back on the road to take on Spring Lake Park. But that's going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score from Anoka High School. It's the Tornadoes in 4 sets. They win 25-16, 16-25, 25-13, and 25-23. Want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. For the entire crew, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young, saying goodnight.